Hey everyone, so I'm finally here to do my kind of like reaction slash discussion video for the glorious 7 minutes that they released to us from the first episode of Shadowhunters. I actually tried to look somewhat presentable today, so yeah. Alright, so this 7 minute sneak peek was released on Saturday during the New York Comic Con when the Shadowhunters, when the cast and the crew were having their panel. So it was released on Saturday, and on Saturday I woke up and I just went on YouTube and like a friend of mine had texted me and everybody's like, oh my god, the sneak peek, the 7 minutes. I'm like, oh, I need to watch this ASAP. So I literally like put on a t-shirt and just recorded myself watching it because like I didn't have time that day to do this, but I wanted to get my like reactions while I still could because I did not want to wait 2 days to watch it because, I mean, come on. So the sneak peek was like a little bit over 7 minutes long. I put in my reaction in this video in case anybody wants to just watch me watch it because I freak out, and if I look like I'm tearing up, it's probably because I am, because it was amazing. So I think I will put a little thing for to so you can fast, oh my god, this hair, so you can fast forward to like when I'm actually talking about what I saw. Yeah, so I will put that in and you can watch that or you cannot, and you can fast forward to my discussion part.
You got no place to hide, and I'm feeling like a villain, got a hunger inside. One look in my eyes and you're running, cause I'm coming, gonna eat you alive. Your heart hits like a drum, the chase has just begun. Better stay clever if you wanna survive. Once you cross the line, you'll be wishing you would listen when you meet your demise. Your heart hits like a drum, the hunt has just begun.
Alright, so I just finished watching the sneak peek again just so I could have it better fresh in my memory. And I have a little bit of notes here because, I mean, there was a lot of stuff and I wanted to talk about all of it. The first thing I want to talk about was that song. Like, how perfect was that song? It's called Monster by this girl named Ruel. I don't know, that's her name, that's what showed up. It was such a good song. It sounded cool, like the beat was really cool. Her like voice was nice and kind of high pitch and with like a dark kind of sound to the song, and it was brilliant. I loved it. Whoever picked that song for the show was amazing. It was amazing because it was so good. You know when you walk out of an action movie or something and you're just like, yeah, I'm about to go jump off a cliff with my car with Vin Diesel inside. I'm about to go, you know, samurai somebody in the face because I'm just awesome. That is what the song made me feel like. It was so good. So the first person that we see in this sneak peek is Alec. And I don't think that this sneak peek is the first 7 minutes of the show. I think it's like probably after Clary has like a little birthday party with Simon and or something. And then, oh, okay, we're going to go to the club. Because in the book, that's literally the first page is when they are in line at the club and they're about to go in. But I don't think that's where they're gonna start off the show, because I mean, we need a little bit of like who these people are, who Simon Clary, who these people are, like why it's a not why it's her birthday, but it's her birthday, so that's why they're gonna go to the club, da 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 da. So as I said, the first person that we see is Alec, and he is in the back. They are all, like, tracking this demon. And the way the demon, like, shapeshifted and changed into all those different people was so cool. I love that. They were like, boom, and I'm this other guy, and boom, I'm this, like, sexy girl that's walking towards the club. It was so cool. And then we see Easy with her, like, blonde wig, which I just thought was so funny. And so, she does the thing that we saw in the trailer, where she vroom, and then the rune appears, and I'm guessing that was like the strength rune, because then they go zipping into the air. And I was seeing some people were like, why are they flying? I don't think they were flying. I think that was just the strength rune is supposed to give them strength, obviously, but in the books I don't think they're supposed to give them like that much strength. But I really like that they included that in the show, because it makes sense, doesn't it? Like, they're fighting demons and vampires and werewolves. Well, not werewolves. But, yeah, they're fighting these creatures that are so much stronger than them. So it makes sense that they would need to, like, have these abilities in order to fight and defeat them. So, brava on the writers. You did great. And then I was kind of not sure about the whole room thing, about how, like, they got the stele. Such a funny word. I pronounce it steel in the books when I was reading, and then I watched the panel, they're like, stele. I'm like, oh, that's how you say it. So yeah, anyways, when Izzy did the thing on her arm and it appeared, as you know, that's not how it works, but again, it makes sense. Like, I was thinking about it, and in the books, how annoying is it that before they go into battle, every time they have to like have or do it themselves, or they have somebody else put the runes on them. So I mean, for time and whatever for the show, it makes sense for them to just like boom and have all of the runes be on them already, and then just have them like go over it so that it can be activated or something. I mean, that's pretty smart actually. And then we get all of them. We get Izzy and Jace and Alec. I was about to say demon. They're on top of that thing, and then they all jump down together, and they're like super looking super like awesome. And then the next scene we get is of this demon turned like woman walking towards Pandemonium, and it's pandemonium demon. I was like, yes, that's awesome. That I love that. I love it. And so the next scene that we get is with Clary, and she's with Simon and Maureen actually, and then Simon's van that we don't really get to see, but we've all seen pictures of it, and it's amazing. But yeah, and then Jace like runs into Claire, and she's like, excuse me, watch where you're going. And he's like, you can see me? And she's like, yeah. And he's like, you have the sight. That was so lame, but it was fine. It was so funny. He's like, you have the sight. Like, okay, that's the first thing that you tell somebody when, like, okay. It was just a really funny first interaction between Clary and Jace. So yeah, back to Maureen. If y'all remember from the book, I had to ask my friend who had just recently read the books, but she was that younger girl. She was like, I don't know, like 14 in the books. And, she was like kind of Simon's like one little young groupie who was turned into a vampire later. I don't remember if she died or not, but she was that character, and they're making her like part of a trio with Simon and Clary, and I kind of like it. And then we get the scene after Clary's like, can we all just be more sophisticated than we really are? And she walks into the club, and then we get the scene goes to Jason, Izzy, and Alec, and they're walking through the club, and they're following that demon, and they're gonna follow her into the, into the back of the club to kill him. And so, Jace is looking amazing, walking through all the people, and then, Izzy is walking through. She has, like, that little smile on her face. She looks so great. And then Alec is in the back, because that's very Alec. He's, like, he's the older one, so he's a protector, and he's, like, always in the back. He was, too, when they were, following the demon outside. He was in the very back, because then it was Izzy and Jace. So I really like that they incorporated that, because that's very Alec. That's something that he would do. And, there was this gif that made me laugh so hard. I don't know if you've seen it, but it's Alec, and he's walking through the club, and he passes by this dude. He's like walking past him, and the gif is like hashtag, oh, excuse me, fellow heterosexual man. And then when Alec is walking through the club, and then when they finally get to the back where the demon is, and Alec looks so grumpy. I thought it was hilarious, because that's such his character. They're doing so well with portraying the character. You know, the actual show and the scenes and some of the events, they're gonna change. It's fine. It's totally inevitable and it's fine and I'm excited for it to happen. But they're just staying so true to the characters and the personalities, and I'm so excited for that. So, and then we get our first glimpse of Magnus, and so this is his club. We know that now. I don't know if they said that explicitly, because I know that I was like, I thought that they were going to do that, but I don't know if they were like, yeah, that the Pandemonium is going to be Magnus's club. But he's like, no circle, clave, whatever members allowed in my club. I'm like, it's his club, which is something that would, that Magnus would totally do. Didn't he do that in the Bane Chronicles? He like owned some bar in the 20s during Prohibition or something. So yeah, I'm so glad that they had Magnus be the club owner, because I mean, doesn't that just make sense? Like, I'm sure that his house, his apartment, whatever, is gonna be like the penthouse on top of the club. I mean, obviously. And so, oh, what if they like pull an Arrow on us and they have more scenes in the club because of the fact that Magnus's loft thing is probably gonna be on top of the club? Oh, interesting. So yeah, we're going more with Magnus. He has like the run-in with those two members, Alaric and that other dude. Don't remember the names. But he was so good. Oh my god, the acting. He's such a good actor. And you know how ABC Family, some of the acting, like Pretty Little Liars, Jesus, so cheesy sometimes. Oh my god, like the acting is just wow. Not anything on the actual actors themselves, but just the way it's written in that show. Anyways, I'm going on to Pretty Little Liars. But Magnus, Harry, is so good. And he was just like very, because Magnus, we know, is a very, you know, elaborate guy. He's very just like fancy and glitter and what? And you know, just how he is. And so Harry is really bringing Magnus to life, and I am so excited to see it more, because oh my god, it was so good. It was just so good. And then the magic that he did with the ta, and then he was like in the air like, oh, I've endured more, and he's like, you've inflicted more. And I was just, it was spot on, it was great. I loved it. And then the cat eyes, oh my god, the special effects, oh my god, get out of here. The cat eyes, his eyes look great. The magic, like the actual, what he was doing with his hands, it was pretty average special effects, which is to be expected. I'm not complaining at all. But the eyes were really well done. His, the yellow and the pupil and the how it was, it looked really good. All right. And then after that, we pan back to that little, I don't know, like VIP area in the back of the club where Jace is talking to that demon. And he's like, Izzy. And then she, I'm sure they like plan that out, or that's something, I mean, you know, that's something that she does. My dog just escaped out of my room. But that's something that she does. She was like the distraction kind of while he went to go get her. And then once like the fight erupted, Alec and Izzy would all join in, and then they would all like Shadowhunter bro fight. It was just, yeah, more on that later. Okay, so next part, then we go back to Clary. And I know I was saying this in one of the other videos that I made. I was like, why is Clary alone? She wasn't alone. She was just alone for a second because she was following Jace. Simon and Maureen were getting drinks. So that cleared that up for me. And then she gets that guy and she's like, wow, somebody works out. And she's like, hey, cool contacts. I'm like, oh, you poor innocent child. We're going to learn so much in the next few days. Your mind is just going to be blown. All right, so back to Jace and him being all super close to that demon lady. And so that was very Jace. Oh my god, he's getting Jace so good. Like, they really understand their characters. I'm just blown away by how much, like, how they're so dedicated to this show. And in the panel, okay, quick little thing. I watched the panel, it was like 50 minutes if you guys watched it, and I wrote notes to talk about the panel, because just a lot of stuff happened in the panel. So I don't know if any of you are interested in me doing another, because this was going to be super long already. But if any of you are interested in me doing a kind of discussion for the panel, just because like they said a lot of things that were really cool. They announced the date of the show, January 12th, like, yeah, so if any of you are interested in me doing, like, a quick video talking about the panel, let me know and I will definitely do that, because, I mean, I can just talk Shadowhunters all day, so more benefit to me. Okay, let's get back on track to talk about, when they were in the back of the club, and Jace is like, oh, last chance to hand over the mundane blood or whatever, and the Seraph Blade just comes out, and then Clary, being just Clary, she's like, ah, watch out, and she pushes the demon out of the way. And it was really cool, because if you remember in the movie, that's literally the only thing that I liked about the movie was that there were pretty decent special effects with the demons and stuff. Like the first demon, the like dog looking thing that attacked Clary in her house after she went back to her home to look for Jocelyn, aka Mama Game of Thrones lady. And so yeah, in the movie, the dog thing, like the mouth splits open like in four different ways, and the demon in the club in the show did the same thing. So I thought that was cool, and it looked really cool too. Like the special effects are awesome in the show. I'm loving it. And then Jace pushes her out of the way, and she's just like, yeah. Like she kept going for a while too. That was funny. And then Jace pushes Clary out of the way, and then we get thing. To Izzy, and she pulls out her whip, and it's just like it crawls down her arm, and then she like starts doing her Indiana Jones stuff, and that was great. We got a little bit more of Izzy fighting, like a second or two after, later into the fight. And until Alec showed up, I don't know why. Until Alec showed up, I'm just like Alec, where are you? And then he showed up. I'm like, there he is. And there was like the whole, they were having the Parabati. I like saying Parabati. What are you gonna, anyways, they had their fight. They had their Parabati fight, and I thought it was great because they were like sharing the sword and they were fighting together, and it was just so, so great. I loved it. Okay, and then another thing, that they changed in the show from the books that I also really like, in the book, you know, Clary freaks out because she sees Jace kill the demon, right? And so in the show, she picks up the Starfleet because she's like so curious, like, yeah, let's just pick up this Star Wars looking sword that this guy just pulled out of his, you know, pocket. So that's smart, Clary. And so she grabs it, and the Starfleet comes out, and Jace takes advantage of the situation and like puts the demon on the blade, and so like she basically kills him because she's holding the sword, and she's like, oh. And so I like that they included that, because having her like accidentally kind of kill the demon freaks her out more. And so, I mean, it's better because, like I said, it freaks her out more rather than just being like, oh my god, I saw this guy kill somebody. No, she was actually the one to do it, so she's like more scared, which is good. So yeah, I loved the fight scene. I cannot, like I said in one of the other videos, I think I am so excited for all the fight scenes. I love watching fights on TV. Like, I've seen so many like samurai movies. I don't know, have you guys ever seen that movie Fearless? I watched that a long time ago, and I love that movie because like all the martial arts is so cool. Anyways, I'm like going off on a way different tangent. I'm so excited for the fight scenes. They're gonna be so cool. I love the style of the Shadowhunter fighting, and it's like with the swords and with a whip and then with this and with that, and it's so cool, and I'm excited to see it all come together in later scenes, and just excitement everywhere. Okay, so then we're done with the fight scene, and Clary like zooms out of there real quick, and she I don't know if she bumps into Harry, god, I need to stop saying Harry, Magnus. And so she runs out. Oh my god, I laughed so hard during the part, the quick like 2 seconds where she's running past Simon and Maureen. I'll see if I can put a picture somewhere because it was so funny. Simon is holding like these two martinis, and I just totally thought of the part in the last Jurassic Park movie, the margarita guy. Do you guys know the margarita guy? Remember when all the pterodactyls are flying and then the guy has a margarita and he's like, ah! It totally reminded me of that, and I laughed so hard. It was so great. So yeah, and then she goes, and then she runs into Harry. God, she runs into Magnus, and he's like the whole acting, his face with the eyes and the who are you? Like, on point, Harry. It was great. And she's like, sorry, because she remembered. So she's remembering. So she's gonna go home and be like, Mom, all this stuff happened, and then you know the rest of the book's gonna happen. And so she runs out of there, gets into a cab. Go cab, and then the two guys, you know, come up all TV show style, and then that's the end of the clip. And yeah, so yeah, I think that's all I have to say about that, like the individual, like specific parts. The promo and the trailer did not do it justice. Like, a lot of people were like, oh, these little things are not the same, and like, okay, whatever. Like, I'm so annoyed by the people that are like, it's not going to be like the book. Yeah, it's not going to be like the book. So, I mean, get on with it. It's going to be great. But yeah, like I said, the promo and the trailer, the like minute and a half trailer, did not do the actual show, the scenes, justice, because it was great. Like, it totally exceeded my expectations, and I know that the show was going to be amazing. If that's the first episode of the first season, imagine 2-3 seasons from now. Imagine City of Heavenly Fire. Oh my god. I